preacher, the prophet, the psychic, coming back at you again with another video. Okay, people, let me tell y'all what's happening. This is a bad sign. This is a bad sign. Y'all remember I took an upload a video last week. You know, I just threw the video out. It was about this homeless dude that he hangs out in this park where I play tennis sometimes. I don't play that much in the park, but I go to see the people that play tennis there. You know, they're some of my tennis partners, so I go there and talk to them. But there's a homeless dude that hang in the park, and I told y'all in the video last week, I called it they call him a crazy homeless dude, but this homeless dude, I think he used to play tennis, but he said that Nadal is not going to win the French Open this year, and he said, Magic Man, mark my word, and he gave some deep reasons why. He said Nadal's level has been dropping. He said nobody really realized except for him and maybe the tennis prophet. And listen, let me just say this. Listen. And he said that it started with Fognini. He said that when Nadal lost that first set against Fognini, he said that was a bad sign. Even though Nadal won and took care of Fognini, like 6-0 or 6-1 the third set, or 6-2 or whatever it was. And the guy said also Nadal was down. Oh no, before that, he said Nadal barely beat the Djokovic. He said in the first set, the Djokovic, that could have went either way. Nadal barely got out of the first set tiebreaker. Then he did beat the Djokovic 6-3 the second set, but he said he really barely beat the Djokovic. And so then he also said he said that Zverev had him 2-0 the third set. It looked like Zverev was going to win. And the rain came and saved Nadal. So this homeless dude said Nadal's level has been continuously dropping. Okay? Now, people, now, I know there's a rain delay. It was a rain delay. Well, not rain delay. The rain, the match was suspended. And Nadal, he was leading 6-4, 6-4, but he's down love 3, okay, and against Balleli. What's his name? Balleli. I always forgot what his name is. But listen, Nadal was down love 3, and people, this is a bad sign. I'm not going to say Nadal is not going to win the French Open, but I will say this. Nadal fans should be wary. Listen, Nadal probably going to come and win this match. No, he's going to win this match. But people, this is a bad sign. I'm not going to say I agree with the homeless dude's conclusion. His conclusion is that Nadal is not going to win the French Open. I'm not going to make a conclusion, but I will agree. I agree with the homeless guy analysis. Nadal's level has been dropping. Now, one thing people don't understand about this level stuff. People, let me tell y'all something. One Federer fan said this last year, and kudos to them. They were aware of Federer's level droppage. One Federer fan said that Federer has not played top level tennis since the Wimbledon, okay, away last year. That Federer fan was right, okay. People, even, okay, let's just say this here. Now, you might say, what has this got to do with Federer now? You're talking about Nadal's level dropping. What has this got to do with Federer? No, people, I'm finna show y'all how these great players like Federer and Nadal, their level can drop, even if they're winning, and it's dropping. And only the really level conscious people, like that homeless dude who y'all think is crazy, and like the tennis prophet, we be watching that. Even if Nadal's winning, we can see the signs. Now, I'm going to go back to Federer, people. Listen. Okay. So, Federer, okay, he beat Cilic in the Wimbledon. Actually, you know what? I almost want to disagree with the Federer fan, but I disagree with the Federer fan a little bit. The Federer fan Because I said that the Federer hasn't played top-level tennis since the Miami Open of 2007 when he dusted Nadal straight sets. And his Federer fans say, no, it was the Wimbledon 2017 a few months later because he said Federer didn't give up a set. So I agree with that. However, though, when Federer beat Cilic, that really wasn't a top level. And I know Cilic had a blister, so it was sort of tricky for Federer. You know when you're playing somebody, they play like they're injured, then they start playing like they're not injured. And it was sort of tricky for Federer, so he had to try to get out of that in straight set. So luckily he did. Okay, but it was a little tricky, but he didn't really play well in that finals, though. Okay, but leave that alone. But let's go with what the Federer fans said. Federer hasn't played. Now remember, Federer finally went on vacation the 1st of April. But I want y'all to see how his level had dropped way back after the Wimbledon. Okay. So Federer wins the Wimbledon. Okay, he gets injured, y'all know, in the finals of the Montreal against Zverev. Okay, and then he pulls out of Cincinnati. He tries to play but he was injured, really. And the level wasn't back at time. He tries to play the U.S. Open. He does the best he can and gets to, the quarters or whatever, and loses against Del Potro. Okay, then, he has a little bit of time before the Laver Cup that they did last year. He sort of got back to a good B level, not a super level, but it's like a B level, okay? And he played all right in the Laver Cup, all right, okay? And then he comes to Shanghai. He sort of is playing okay. Some things, I think, against Del Potro. I think he played Del Potro in the semifinals, and it was three sets. So people thought maybe Nadal was going to definitely beat him in the finals if he went with Del Potro three sets in the semifinals. I don't know, whoever he played in the semis, don't take my word for the Del Potro. But it didn't look like Federer was going to win. Most people, except for the tennis prophet, I call that one right. I took Federer in straight sets. He put it together and played at a good high. I don't think it was his highest level, but it was a high level, enough to beat Nadal straight sets on the hard court. Okay, then Federer goes to Basel. He wasn't his best level, but it was a good level, all right, B level. He put that together, beat Del Potro in Basel. Then he pulls out, okay, whatever he was feeling, level-wise or injury-wise, he pulls out of the Paris Masters. Then he plays in the ATP finale. See, level still, he's still not back at high level, though. Everybody said Federer winning, Federer fans happy. But, yeah, he's winning, but I know this is not Federer's top level. And that Federer fan that said it in the comment, he knows that. So Federer goes in the ATP finale, and he's not playing really. He's playing okay, but it ain't no top level. The level is suspect. And then he gets Goffin. The level is like up and down. He wipes Goffin off the court the first set, 6-2, and then he loses the match. Y'all know that. Okay, so level dropping, level tripping. Then he comes to the Australian Open. He puts together a good level to get to the finals, a good level. I'm not saying it was his top level. And he wipes Cilic off the court like the first set, and then the level start tripping, and then he go back, Cilic win a set, Federer wins a set, the level going up and down. But, and then let me just, then Federer heads towards like the Rotterdam where he becomes number one. His level was tripping because those matches was close, like with Hossi and all that. Even though he became number one, that wasn't, his level was already continuously dropping. Okay, but Federer was, he's great enough now that he can some way take that old solid B minus level and beat most players except for the really top ones. Okay, and the big five was all injured, so he didn't have to worry about them, but he could beat these little clowns below him. Okay, and so finally the level still tripping. He comes to the Miami Open. Level. The tennis prophet knows this even before he loses against Del Potro. Federer level is tripping. He barely beat Cilic. Okay, and then against Del Potro, he has double match point, but the level runs out. He blows that, and then y'all know the rest of the story. The level, not only is it low now, against Kokonagas in the Miami Open, the level breaks. And that's why Federer went on vacation. His level broke. And that's why, people think, oh, he didn't play the French Open because he's scared of Nadal. No. He didn't have any level anymore. That's why he said it. He said it sort of the way I said it. He said usually he can put together, he can figure things out. And he was frustrated. He said this is the first time things didn't come back together. His level broke. That's why he went on vacation. Now, you may say, now that I've said this, let me come back to Nadal. People, I've been the last month or so, I've been watching Nadal's level. And there are signs like that crazy homeless guy said. He said Nadal, like he been barely getting out of stuff. Just the way Federer was. And finally, that level stuff, it either just goes too low and the better players like a Zverev, who's playing good level now, and a Djokovic, they could get you. So I'm not going to say Nadal is not going to win the French Open, but I'm going to say this is not a good sign. Even if he win this match, this is not a good sign, okay? And if somebody came up to me and said, Magic Man, let's bet, I bet you $1,000 Nadal won't win the French Open. You know what? I won't bet him, but I think about it. I would actually think about it. I'd say, no, thanks. But I would think about it. And I may even tell them, I call you back tomorrow if I decide I'm going to. But I probably wouldn't bet it. Because Nadal can't put together his level. Now, let me say this here in closing. The reason I wouldn't bet that Nadal won't win the French Open, I think there's some troubling signs now, some bad signs. There's some omens that he may not win, that somebody like a Zverev could beat him, or even a Djokovic, if he dropped down this low, what we said in the first round. This is just the first round, and he's having a difficult time, okay? But the reason why I wouldn't bet against Nadal right now, because he can put back the level to a high level. But sometime, like Federer, what happened to Federer? Sometime you can't. You may have to go on vacation first and then put it together, okay? Tennis preacher, tennis prophet. It's going to get really interesting. Tennis psychic, signing off. Have a good one.
Ha 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 ha!